Hello everyone. Today we are going to start the topic 3-phase induction motor. And we all know induction motor was invented by Nikola Tesla 100 years back, and still now it consists of more than 60% of the total load of the total power system. Induction motor is very popular because of its simple structure and robust nature. So some of the features of induction motor are the sealing pan, mixer grinder. All the home appliances that we use at home are all of the induction motor. So now we will go toward the basic, a very basic principle of 3-phase induction motor. So first we will start with the construction of the induction motor, then we will move toward its working. So going toward the construction, a 3-phase induction motor consists of a stator, that is the stationary part, it is shown here. It is the stationary part. It has some stator slots inside this. The slots have a 3-phase winding through which we are giving the input supply. This IA, IB and IC are the 3-phase current that we are giving. This one IA, IB and IC. This 3-phase supply is given to the stator winding of the machine. And we have a rotor, that is the rotating part. And the rotor also consists of some winding that are known as the rotor winding. So what happens when we give supply to the 3-phase stator winding? A flux is produced inside the area. This is the area, and the rotor is connected to the stator by the area. There is no electrical connection. So when we give a supply to the stator winding, what happens? A magnetic flux is produced inside the rotor, inside the area, because wherever there is a current, there is a magnetic field, direction of which we can see it by the right hand thumb rule, which shows that thumb shows the direction of current and the curls of our finger show the direction of the flux like this. If this is the current, the flux will be in this direction. So when a 3-phase supply is given to the stator, a flux, a magnetic flux is generated inside this area. The property of this flux is very special, and is that this flux rotates inside the area. It is not like a single phase flux or a DC flux. This flux is different from that as it rotates inside the air gap in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction, depending upon the type of connection given. And the speed of the rotation is given by the synchronous speed. So we can say that the speed with which the flux is rotating is known as the synchronous speed, the formula for which is 120 into F by P, where F is the input supply frequency, while P are the number of poles in the rotor. So now what will happen when this rotating flux or this changing flux, we can say it as a changing flux or d phi by dt. They have a changing flux. So then this rotating flux or the changing flux links with these rotor winding, it induces an EMF by the famous Faraday law that states that whenever a conductor is placed inside a rotating magnetic field or a changing magnetic field, EMF is induced in that loop. We can say this E equal to N d phi by dt. So now we have an EMF inside this rotor. What happens is that the winding of this rotor are short-circuited at the ends. They are short-circuited So as an EMF is induced, a current starts to flow inside this loop. Now we should know about the Lorentz force law, that whenever a current carrying conductor is placed inside a magnetic field, it experiences a force. The force is given by the Fleming's left hand rule, that is, the thumb gives the direction of force, this is B, and this is the direction of current. That means this is the force, the thumb, this is the magnetic field, and this gives the current. So it will rotate in a certain direction, and the speed of rotation is given by MR, that is the rotation speed of the rotor. So there is one more term known as slip. NS was the speed of the magnetic field, and NR was the rotor speed, and slip is given by NS minus NR by NS. That was for now. We can study more about it.